Welcome to the tutorial on Web Core Form Inheritance. Form Inheritance is a new feature of Web Core 1.3. First of all, I'm going to start to explain what Form Inheritance is, because of course we all know object-oriented class inheritance, so what is Form Inheritance about? And then I'm going to build a project from scratch using RAD Studio that will use form inheritance, and then we're going to look at the bundled example that is being included in your TMS Web Core installation, so you can have a detailed look at the whole functionality after watching this tutorial. Class inheritance is the principle of object-oriented programming. A few of you might smile because Visual Basic 6.0 has been one of the most famous programming languages around, and guess what? They didn't have inheritance for classes. So what most people don't realize when they start with Delphi, that every form is actually a class, and forms in Delphi in the VCL are derived from tform. So in TMS Web Core, every form, as long as it's not an Electron application, is derived of tWebForm. When you create a new web application using the wizard, you get the main form, and the main form says something like tForm1 equals class tWebForm. So tForm1, which has the name Form1 in the object inspector, is your form class. And if you work with it in code, you use Form1 as the name. That is your object instance that you reference in your code. In addition to the source code, in Delphi, we're used to using the form designer. And on the form designer, you have a collection of graphical controls. And what makes Delphi, or what made Delphi so powerful in the past, is that you could inherit forms, and the inherited forms would contain the graphical elements from the base form. So in addition to the source code, you already had a graphical representation of the inheritance. With TMS Web, this is no different, and this is the big new feature. So looking at the next slide, we see that we have on the left a base form, and on this base form we have a web panel, and in this panel we have a username and password edit control with two buttons. And then we derive from this base form a new form, and automatically or through inheritance, the top part of the form is determined by the parent class being your base form. And then you can add to the class, or you can even make changes to the components that you inherit. And all this is supported by the Visual Designer inside of the RAD Studio IDE. Let's build a project from scratch and have a look at form inheritance. So far new TMS web application. And here we have the main form inside of unit1.pass, and the object inspector gives us the class name tForm1 and also the object instance Form1. In source code, this looks as follows. tForm1 equals class tWebForm, and the variable declaration Form1 is of type tForm1. So as you can see, a form object instance is just another object as any other. Just because the VCL makes it so easy to work with forms and to design your forms, you quickly forget that this is actually something that makes Delphi so powerful. And all these principles have been taken into account for TMS Web Core, which makes web development with TMS Web Core so comfortable. So let's reenact the example with the two edit controls and the two buttons. So we have two edit controls and two buttons. And of course it's web buttons and web edits. And both of these controls have been hosted in a web panel. So we're going to drop a web panel as well. Going to increase the size. We're going to set the caption to nothing. And you can select these controls, cut them, and paste them into the panel. Of course, you could use anchors and all sorts in order to make certain that if the form is actually inherited, that it looks the way it's supposed to. We're not going to spend any time on that. What we need to do now is we need to name our form. So this is going to be our base form. So we're going to say form base is the name of the form. And of course, I'm going to save the project accordingly. I named the unit U form base, so it becomes clear that it's the base form of the application. or one of the base forms of the application. If we switch to the source code, we see that the IDE makes the changes that we're used to from the VCL. T form base is now the new type for our form, and form base is the object instance of T form base. How can we make this a real base form of another form? For that, TMS included a context menu in the project manager, and here you see that you can click inherit from web form. This is how easy it is to create a derived class or an inherited class of your forms. So unit1.pass has been created, and if we switch over to the source code, we see that no longer the form is derived of tWebForm, it's derived of tFormBase. And what we also notice is that the graphical controls have been copied over or are actually the same as in the base form. So if you make changes to your base form, for example, you say you add another button or you add a list box, for whatever reason, we add a list box here, like this, and then you switch over to your descended class and you see it's also on there. But of course, now in the inherited class, you can add more components. For example, you can add a web memo like this. If you switch between the two, you see the base class, of course, doesn't have the memo, but the inherited class does have the memo. And of course, you also see this in the source code that the derived class only has the web memo instance, but your base class, of course, has all other components. And that is actually the key why you use form inheritance. You would put all the logic for the panel, for the edits, for the buttons, and the list box in this case, you would put that all in your base form, and your inherited form wouldn't have to think about any of that. So you are able to encapsulate certain functionality and interaction of the visual controls in this base class, and then focus on other controls in your inherited forms. I would like to point out one thing, not to make this too complicated, but sometimes in trainings, people point out something that is simply wrong about Delphi. People think that you can only derive once because they consider multi-class inheritance. They consider that only inherit once. That is incorrect. Of course, you can inherit off this class again. And then you have tform2 equals class of tform1, and tform1 is our already inherited form. So you can inherit as often as you want. The only thing you cannot do in Object Pascal is that you add a second class here, because that is something that is C++, for example, specific. C++ can inherit from multiple classes. However, you can inherit as often as you want. And just as a side note, of course, Delphi has the possibility to kind of inherit from multiple class-like things. You can inherit from multiple interfaces. After this detailed view into the form inheritance specifics, I would like to introduce you to the bundled demonstration that comes with TMS Web Core. You find the demonstration in the demo folder under basics, and then there is the directory form inheritance. And there's the TMS Web Form Inheritance demo. The demonstration consists of two forms. You've seen them on the slides, the base form and the inherited form. Let's look at the base form first. The base form has, kind of like the example that we built from scratch, two edit controls, username and password, sign in and create account. And this is totally made up. There is no functionality to sign in or to create an account. This is to demonstrate form inheritance. The inherited form inherits of this form, so this upper part is inherited from the base form. Something that is introduced new in this demonstration, and this is actually a reason why I didn't build this from scratch, because you have to look at it a little bit longer if you've never done this before, so it's not as easy to follow up while I type it. We have two methods inside of our base form. These methods are doLogin and doSignup. If you click on the create account button, doSignup is called, and if you create on the login button, doLogin is called, with the two parameters, the username and the password. And these two methods do nothing but show a show message, either we're performing the login for a user, or please specify a username if you don't know username has been specified, and the same thing for the sign up. So there's nothing special with the password or anything. There's no logic with user accounts. However, both of these methods have been declared as virtual, which means if you go over to the inherited form, which has one additional control, a memo control, you see that we override these methods. And that is actually another object-oriented principle that you can override methods in inherited classes. For that, you have the inherited keyword in the Delphi language, so you can override both methods. Of course, the fingerprint needs to be identical, and they need to be virtual, so you can use override. And then you can use inherited to call the method of the base class. So at this point, inherited actually calls doLogin from the base class. That means this code is executed, and afterwards, this code is executed. It means in addition to the show message, you now also add the text to the web memo. The reason for this also is you would not need to be the owner or the developer of the base form. You could be just responsible to develop the inherited form, and one of your colleagues has written the base form. So that's the number one reason why you use this kind of architecture as well. You don't need to concern yourself with how the base form is implemented. You just call it, inherit it, and then you can concentrate on the stuff that you need to do in your form. So if you run the application, you see that, of course, we only see the derived form. It doesn't make any sense to show the base class because there's no real functionality in the base class. And if you simply leave everything empty, we click sign in, we still get the show message from the base class. And we also don't get any input on the memo because a user is equal to nothing. So let's try to log in a user, Bruno Fierens, sign in, perform a login for user Bruno Fierens, and now the user isn't empty anymore, and we see a login attempt for Bruno Fierens is being logged. So here you see that the show message comes from the base class, and the memo lines are being added to from the inherited form. Hopefully this demo brought some light into form inheritance for you. The demo is available with your TMS Web Core installation, and you have plenty of time to dig into the code and experiment with it. The example is actually pretty good to experiment with certain other things that you can do. You can make changes to the base form, you can make changes to the inherited form, and see how everything affects each other. Thank you very much for your interest in TMS Web Core and form inheritance. See you soon.